brothers and sisters. My name remains Comrade Tony Kabaka. As you all know, today making one year that my property was being destroyed because of politics. So brothers and sisters, please invite your friends. Tony Kabaka has something politely to say. So brothers and sisters, today I wake up, I was being reminded by Facebook, today making 1 year that my property was being destroyed. Well, brothers and sisters, now solicit for me, may God Almighty bless you all. My brothers and sisters, now know what it takes to be an investor. May God continue to bless your investment. And the people that God has never blessed, may God continue to bless you. May God uplift you this year. May God grant you your heart desire. I'm happy today because I'm alive. Today, I need to talk about life in particular. I thank God for my life, that I'm alive. Well, I'm a politician by nature, but I'm a hard-working boy. I cannot say all I've done in my life. The most people that grew up with me here know the job I've involved in. So what triggered me today, most especially my property and what I'm hearing from different places. Well, brothers and sisters, first of all, I'm supposed to be an advocate of the full enhancement of what is happening in Benin. Everybody knows my challenges. That's why I keep mute. My challenges, everybody knows anything I involve in, either they take it to politics, I would say it's because of politics. That was why I did not involve in even the, what do you call it?
Answers
protection.
Answers
protest. I did not involve because I have a challenge. Everybody target all eyes on me. That is why I keep mute. All have been happening since after election, I keep mute. I didn't say a word. A lot of people do say, talk about me. I've not mentioned nobody has seen me. But today is good, I remember today, because today making 1 year. My message goes to my leaders and my politicians, most especially. Please, I don't want anybody to take whatever that is coming out from me today personal. I don't want anybody to use it against me. I want to be transparent and be well confronted with whatever I'm going to say today, besides my anger. First of all, let me thank my brother all over the world, my brothers in diaspora, my brothers and sisters all over the world. My brothers and sisters in diaspora, may God continue to bless you. You guys, may COVID-19 not get to you people. May this Killani X-Men not get to you people, because there's nothing we can do. We have already inside the Nigeria, Africa. There's nothing we can do. I don't have the seed to fight this cause. But God Almighty will wake up one day and solve our problem by using people that is ready to make sure this thing will be over one day. Well, I cannot say in my life I made mistakes. At times, someone made mistakes. Well, what I want to say today, since my property was destroyed, I swear to you, brothers and sisters, please. Brothers and sisters, no politician, no APC leader have ever called me and said, Kabaka, please come and supply sand, come and supply smith, or come and take this 500,000 for your property. I don't have, but God manage this. I know where you are facing. Nobody. If there is any, please, I volunteer the person to come out and tell the world that when this thing happened, I sent my message across to Tony Kabaka. Well, it's not, I don't feel bad. It's what are evolving. It's politics. Politics have turned, it's even more than the courtesy killing. The politics have not, it's more than the contract. Politics is now with something more than the contract. We don't need this. My brothers and sisters, my message goes to my party, APC. When we break up and make up in life, I want to tell my brothers and sisters, both in diaspora, I have a challenge in my mind that normally worry me. Normally worry me. This challenge is this. People say, hey, Kabaka do this, Kabaka kill, Kabaka do that. And the same Kabaka still live here in Benin. Police have not get around to me. They've not seen what I do. If I'm a dubious man, with the challenge I was having in politics, I think the government would have opened my page of my crime in this state. They'll say, this boy, for them to get to my property, they will open my page if I'm committed in this town. If I'm a dubious man in this town, with whatever they are saying on social media, at least I could have not been at home. But in life, it's not what everybody say that you come out and challenge. People normally mention my name to get followers, to get attention because of the name I built for myself. But I thank God Almighty that is guiding me, that is still protecting me till today. That it make anywhere I go, anywhere I enter, the obligation is not from me, it's from God Almighty. So I thank God for my life. But in life, I want to tell you, my brothers and sisters, it's good to be good. So let me go straight to my story. You see, since my property was being destroyed, no politician, APC, we have honorable representatives, we have honorable senators, We have some people in federal. Even though I'm opposition in my state, my message is not going to government. Please don't quote me wrong. My message is going to the federal government, APC, that I belong to. I'm a member of APC, strong member of APC in Edo State. A strong mobilizer of APC. In Edo State, if you go to the profile, both swearing in, both Buhari, second tenor, first tenor, you will see Tony Kabaka activities in Ogbe Stadium, in all rallies that you do. If you are if you are a politician, you have a follower, you use your color and your motivator to support the objection. It's politics, it's a game. So what I'm saying is, my brothers and sisters, I play politics, that's why my property was destroyed. If I support the present government, I think my property could have still been there. But I feel so sad for my people, my APC brothers and sisters, that neglect me. Apart from my national chairman, may God bless you, Adams Ali Oshomole, that seek out the God to send me text, giving me word of encouragement, that he ask about my living. May God continue to bless you, sir. I know I cannot get to you, I cannot reach you now because of what is happening. Baba, there's no day in my life that will forget you, Comrade Adams Ali Oshomole. Today, we enjoy infrastructure you have contributed. No man is perfect. All man is born to make mistakes. Baba, your kudos to you. You did not neglect me. I'm saying this message because I'm hearing a lot of stories that Kabaka, they send him money, they compensate him, they give him a contract. I'm telling you, no APC man, born of a woman or a man, have ever called me and gave me 500,000 apart from my streets. I don't want to mention it. I want to thank my brothers and sisters, my youth, that have been there for me, that is sending me 100,000, 200,000, 300,000, 1 million for me to survive. As I'm talking to you, my hotel was destroyed. I've never tears. If you look at my eyes, tears is running out of me. Because I'm a member of APC. I don't deserve neglect. I worked so effortlessly to make sure my party victorious. But the payback was evil. But we thank God, God keep us alive. But my leaders that neglect me, that feel nothing is happening as nothing is happening, may God continue to bless you all. The time will come. You same leader that say you are representing me, representing Edo State, we will ask you question when the time comes. When something happens to our youth that is a politician, that we all know, what was your contribution and what did you people do? You were representing us. We voted here to make sure APC is victorious. I don't know, APC don't have a good mind. They don't have a unity. I regret it. If there's unity, we were on ground here. We are in federal. A lot of things happened to us. We have been oppressed. A lot of things have happened. I can show you my gate, my house. You see a lot of a gunshot, AK gunshot. In my house, the day Pastor Osage Zeyamu was the camping, I was in his house, in the podium when he was the camping, when they came to my house. Nobody has asked me, what are you faring? Not the only lie they put on me, that I, Kabaka, celebrate 2 billion, be 4 billion in Dubai. God Almighty that created heaven and earth. If I've ever been to Dubai, if I celebrate even 1 billion, may God Almighty squeeze life out of me. I don't think to join this God, because I know God supersedes, even though you are a traditional man, whatever you call yourself. I'm a traditional man, but I call God first. If it is true that I even celebrate 1 billion, may God Almighty squeeze life out of me. You people spread my name to the extent. People are seeing me like evil. And I keep asking questions in social media. And you said I'm this and this. I'm here. Am I above the law? Nobody answer. People keep the news. I saw one day, but somebody come out from social media that Kabaka kill somebody. They beat the person in his house. They made a lot of things. A lot of things, because I was trying to assist at my own time. At my own time. A lot of things happened here in Benin. I mean, some people were immune. When they went to Aunsa Quarter to invade our people, they're sending money from abroad. When they invade Aunsa Quarter, I remember I packed the Aunsa to my house, keep them in my house, with their dollars and gold and packs, worth more than 200 million. Nothing was missing. Before, the Air Force commander now sent troops to come and carry them from my house. The only challenge I was having, I challenged the Air Force commander, said, sir, with due respect, I cannot rescue these 10 people in that kind of crisis. They will all take this money and go away like that. Let them compensate us. They now gave me 500,000 out of the calculation, both the gold that worth more than 100 million and cash that won more than 150 million. It's on social media. Well, brothers and sisters, even when we were being oppressed by our security agency, when they were going out of their normal duty, I told the Kabaka came out to crack in this state before NSAC came up. That was the time of RSF, far back ago. Okay. Even when courtesy we are killing, I came out. How many people did that? But you know what one person told me in abroad? He said, Tony, I'm here in this abroad, it's your contribution. He said, he used Benin, let me speak Benin here, please, sorry. He said, on my sea, I'm done, you are in. On my time, I progress, I didn't say why. I don't know. He's back, he's been there, he's been there. If you cry to me and say you have problems, say go and meet the police. I don't know that I have no support. If they are collecting your property, your land, I'll say go and meet police. Because this is what I was doing. I want to ask question. The Benin that is living here with us, you the youth, and the elders that is living here with us. How many times I, Tony Kabaka, I brought people to your community. Me, standing, you see me fighting you as a community to come and grab land. I don't do it. Ask any community. This Ugbo, I built my house. Ugbo, this place I built my house. Ugbo youth are looking at me. They are watching me. Ugbo elders are watching me. I bought this place twice. When I bought it from the then CDA. The elder said the CDA does not have rights to sell this place and I've already invested. For me not to have a problem, I have to go and meet them, negotiate and pay again. Even my the next property. I cannot mention. I want to tell my brothers and sisters, I'm not as evil as you think. It pains me for my party that neglect me. Up till now, my parties, I saw people in federal that they normally give contracts, supply face masks, supply this, go and do this contract, go and renovate this road. How many have come in? I don't even need contract. Tony Kabaka, take this 500,000 to support yourself. Well, I want to thank my youth that did not neglect me. If you know you have given me money, you have sent me 50,000, 100,000, may God continue to refill your pocket. May God continue to bless you. I came here today because if not the streets, I could have been selling my property now. I have only this property left. My hotel was the second property I have. May God continue. I came out this morning to thank the street and the boys and the entire boys in Edo State, the tired men of Edo State. May God continue to bless you for your support that you have been giving to me. I will call peace for people. I'm ashamed. I won't lie to you, my brothers and sisters. Nobody will understand. I have people that I call. I normally solicit before I can feed. I normally beg before I can feed. I'm not saying this thing because I'm hungry. God have made me. I'm okay. My family are in abroad. I don't know if you understand. Because of this challenge, I took them away. You understand? Somebody help me. I don't want to mention. A lot of people is helping me. And please, I don't want you people to relax. Because you people stay here with me. You grow up with me. You know what I'm capable of. Some people that are swearing my name, they don't even know me. They are just hearing my name. What they heard. Anybody that is close to me will never swear my because he knows me. And I was watching video about a week ago. This message to my brothers, the Togberians. Togberians, we are not enemy. Everybody is looking for his daily bread. You have a family you want to feed. Quote me, and I meet with you, normally meet outside. I don't have crisis with anybody. The only thing that pains me is what I will tell you. I've ever loved of you. Nobody is mentioning my name apart from you. And please, don't drag me into crisis that is happening. Tony Kabaka, I'm in my room. I'm in my house. I don't do anything now. I don't do anything contrary. I don't want anybody to drag my name. Please, everybody saw what has been happening. Tony Kabaka has not said no word. I saw a video, somebody mentioned my name, that Kabaka is the one supporting you. I feel embarrassed. My brother, I have a community in Ulemo. Upper Nebosa is not my community. If I step my leg in Upper Nebosa, I will say maybe once in my life. If I step my leg in my community, I will say maybe 3 times in my life. In Ulemo. Nobody see me. I don't do community things. I hate it. Even though people have given me land, I don't normally take. A lot of community, you are watching me. They give me land. I don't go. I swear. Anybody that is in community that will say the truth and nothing but the truth, beside the grievances, beside the party, whatever, please, I don't do that. So if my brother has a problem in community, I will follow him to go. If anybody complains to me, I will follow him to go and negotiate dialogue to make sure the person is secure his property. And I'm helping. I cannot say all the good I'm doing. I'm not a social media that if I do this from somebody, I will come out and be saying it. Please, my Togbenian brothers, I'm not your enemy. I'm saying this because of what is training of recently. So brothers and sisters, you are working there, tomorrow we can work together. Tomorrow you can join me, tomorrow I can join you. So please, don't take whatever the Apple politics is, it has come and gone. So please, any property, anybody having dispute in property, don't mention my name. I don't want to mention people's name or say any community's name. Please, I beg you. Everybody know what I'm facing now. Can I start all over again? Please, I beg you. You are my brothers. What are you going to gain if you spoil my name? What are you going to gain if I lost my life? What are you going to gain? See, at least understand my little contribution. I beg you. Please, brothers and sisters in diaspora, I thank you all for your support over my life. My brothers in the street, my brothers in Benin, may God Almighty bless you. May God Almighty refill your pocket. I feel bad today. Today is 1 year that my property was being destroyed. So I felt so bad. I was being neglected by APC that have power to the federal and both everywhere. Thank you, brothers and sisters. Thank you. God bless you.
Nigga, let me use the opportunity to encourage you. We know the suspense.
Amen.
Don't worry. We, your follower, your youth, we will never leave you. Even though the enemy, they are trying to belittle you, they are trying to bring you down, but with God on our side, you will spring up again in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let me also use the opportunity to advise my APC leaders. The fight of Tony Kabaka that led to his demolition of the hotel is because of the APC. Let me open it to everybody. It's because of the fight. Because there's nobody that is not happy to fight for his people, his supporter, or his leader. Tony lost that hotel because of the APC. We have senator. We have House of Rep. Tony, our leader, is a Nigerian man. And that hotel was built in Nigeria, not in Dubai. So you that is representing us as APC senator, House of Rep, even the minister, you have never in today mark 1 year now. You have never given our leader a token of a support that you know what when you know what happened to him. And let me say, I advise our youth who are still coming up, my brother. You have to learn. Don't give yourself for people to use. Because
when you fall, not to cry.
At all. When you fall, nobody wants to rise you up again. But I want to use the opportunity to invite our youth. They do good. Don't talk politics to a confront. What they are using it for now. Tomorrow you will regret it. You will regret it because you need to lay a good foundation. No matter what you are saying concerning our brother, even up to today, I've been hearing Tony did this, but today, Tony is still working with his bedroom. He's singing alone, moving to anywhere, but he will still go and come back. But you that say you never asked, and you that be doing the evil, you are hiding under the garment. calling people's name who have never killed a flag. Until you hear this man, the leader, Tony Kabaka, you don't know who he is, but just call the name whose God has already anointed. Don't be jealous. Don't be jealous because he's growing, because he has made it. My brother, whatever you do to your fellow brother, will come back to you.
My last message, I want to use this video to send message to somebody. Abad, I don't offend you. Abad, any video you do, you mention my name. Have I wronged you in any way? Have I fought you in any way? You are a small boy. My mother last born with you. You are 8 foot. Abad, anything you do, you want to use Kabaka name. After politics, there's life. Abad. I beg you, Abba, please, after politics, there's life. I want to beg you, Abba, stop mentioning my name and stop using my name anyhow. Abba, I'm 50-something years. You can't fight me physically. Why I keep immune? Because if I block you and fight you, they will say I'm fighting Governor Folua. What have I done to you? When we were together, I was helping you. You were fighting for me when I was having problems. What just come out? I saw your video again. You were mentioning my name during the crisis of you and Akobe. I don't want it, Abba. I'm not your mate. I'll pay my due. There's no how you can mention whatever you are saying on social media that you will reign more than me in life. That you will do what I've done in life. My message to you, Abba, I beg you, because Abba Jackie is my uncle. If we rule and live, me and you will remain in this Benin. Abba, I beg you, the family of Abba, please, I beg you, use this medium to advise your son over Tony Kabaka issue. And my message, again, Ebo, I help you. Ebo, I've not wronged you. Ebo, I remove you from Ogola to my heart to care for you. From there, I plan how you rent your house. You get married. I was there for you. Ebo, I remember vividly after I support you in your father burial, somebody spray bad money for you. You romance. They take you to Celestial Church. Ebo, I'm sending this message because of the pain I have today. They take, even though I wrong you in any way, you should remember this. They take you to Celestial Church, Ebo. You wrong man. Ebo, I'm saying yes, I'm talking to you. You wrong man. I called your wife. I said, Ebo, madam, where is Ebo? Ebo, my boy. Ebo, the king. I called your wife. I challenged your wife. I went to go and remove you from where they took you to. They took you to Aladura Church in Rousse. I went to go and remove you, Ebo. Ebo, you Roman, I took care of you. I made sure you become normal human being today. Ebo, what have I done for you? Ebo, anything you do, you swear that you speak, spelling my name all over. Ebo, it pains me. You know why I said that for your issue? Because I know how I contributed to your life. The anger you were having with me, because I didn't empower you, I went to go and empower Shaba. That is not for you to just say I should just die or be doing all nonsense about me, Ebo. Ebo, what you are doing to me, of the people that have not done it. I don't know what I'm doing. Ebo, you romance, I spend my money. I made sure, Ebo, I revive you to life again. You were acting as a senior son in your father's family. They now harm you. You Roman. Your wife that you married today is my witness. Ebo, it pains me for you. May God forgive you. This, I said yes for your issue. It pains me so well. Because I know what's going in your life, Ebo. May God continue to bless you. Thank you. God will take them back.